Next up, my journey 600 feet into the crater of a volatile inferno where scientists are looking for signs that could end up saving thousands of lives. Masaya in Nicaragua is so feared that religious crusaders once tried to exorcise the devil out of its heart. Lake Nicaragua, the largest body of fresh water in Central America, and home to Jicaro Island, a National Geographic unique lodge. Nicaragua has 19 active volcanoes, including Masaya, a ticking time bomb that could go off at any moment. That's where I'm headed. Just look at the size of this volcanic crater. It's about 7 miles across, and in the center of it, another volcano was born, Masaya. One of the most volatile in the world that's erupted 13 times in just the last 30 years. I'm making my way around the crater of Masaya Volcano to some volcanologists who risk their lives out here on this deadly beast. Part of what makes volcanoes so dangerous is that they're unpredictable, and no one really knows when this one will erupt again. With a million people living just 15 miles away, geologists have set up shop in the heart of this ticking time bomb to figure that out. Guys, nice to see you. Hey. Working on one of the sensors?
Yes, Phil.
Yeah?
Yes, we are taking care of the maintenance of the gas instruments that we use to monitor the mouth of hell.
The mouth of hell?
Yes.
Yeah, where did that name come from, by the way?
It was from the Spanish conquistadors, you know?
Yeah.
A few hundred years ago, they thought that it was gold and fire coming from hell. So that's why it's named after that, you know?
Amando and his team monitor a network of 80 sensors, gauging Masaya's conditions and surrounding atmosphere so they can try to predict the next eruption. It seems to me that without these warning systems, the people would be really vulnerable. Yeah. This is the only means of defense for them?
As you say, when we detect something that is dangerous, we send information immediately to the local authorities.
In the spring of 2018, earthquake sensors captured vital data on Hawaii's Kilauea volcano, which, after it erupted, reduced 600 homes to ashes. That intel is crucial to missions like this.
It's getting unstable. You can see
the edge is starting to break away.
It's falling apart.
Oh my.
Yes, that's the mouth of hell.
Oh my God. That is really scary looking. Where in the world can you see this? Very few places.
Yeah, very few places.
The lava lakes that form in active volcanoes typically don't last long. But Masaya's has been churning consistently for centuries, making it one of the most active members of the Ring of Fire. I've used some volcanic rocks to make a very rough map, but I want to show you exactly where the Ring of Fire is. It's 25,000 miles long and completely circumnavigates the Pacific Ocean. It runs right through New Zealand, that's why there's a lot of volcanoes there, through Indonesia, Japan, through the top of Russia, all the way down the west coast of America, and then down through Central America, where Nicaragua is, and it continues right down to the end of South America. Almost all of the volcanoes in the Ring of Fire occur along the edges of the Pacific tectonic plate. But Masaya was formed between two smaller plates. About 20 million years ago, the Cocos Plate began sliding under the Caribbean Plate. The energy from this subduction turns solid rock into liquid magma. And when that magma escaped through the Earth's crust, Masaya was born. It's a long way down. So we're good. It's a 60-story drop into this cauldron of toxic gas. This mask will actually filter out the sulfur dioxide that we're expecting down below. You can also get the gases in your eye. And this helmet, for obvious reasons, because
the rim of the crater, there's a lot of falling debris.
I'm going in to meet up with Rodolfo Alvarez, the engineer behind this pulley system built to get scientists in and out of this massive crater.
And it is a lot farther down there than it looks. Everything tied on properly? This is the exciting part. You see the enormity of this volcano. It's incredibly humbling. The roar of the volcano is getting louder and louder. Look at that. That is absolutely magnificent. The blue of the lava. Well, in the distance, I can see the Gulf of Mexico coming.
Descending into this hostile environment of heat and toxic gas is extremely dangerous. But for Rodolfo Alvarez, it's as if it's just another day at the office.
All right. Rodolfo, how you doing?
Well, welcome to the gate of hell.
Oh, my goodness me. That was like, that was just insane, Rodolfo.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm all good. Wow, it got dark so quick, right? Why are you not wearing your gas mask? What's wrong with you?
Oh, because I wear it when I need it.
How do you know? You watch the gases coming up?
Well, by now you don't need the mask, but if you want to keep it, it's no problem.
There is an overwhelming odor down here, like a match that's just being lit. That's sulfur dioxide. And when that gas mixes with the moisture in the air, it forms sulfuric acid. It eats everything. From the cables ferrying the team in and out of Masaya to the sensors that raise the alarm when there's danger.
This is a box that we got them to protect the sensors, the sensor inside.
Because of the
sulfuric acid.
The sulfuric acid.
There are little sensors down the bottom here.
A different sensor for different gases. Those are the ones that are damaged.
The corrosion is really bad, huh?
Yes, actually, it's amazing. If you
all around, I see like corroded
pieces.
Yeah,
you can look in here. I mean, this is like a cable. And we can.
Wow. Look at these joints that have just completely eroded away.
I mean, it's completely destroyed.
And that's from the sulfuric acid?
Yes. You know, you have all this cloud of sulfur, and you can feel it in your eyes. You start, your eyes start itching like hell. I
mean, it's strong.
I mean, it's not pure sulfuric acid, but it's very high percentage.
Man, I just want to keep putting on the mask, and I look at you, you got no mask on.
Well, it's not.
I don't know how you do it.
We can go that way, and you can actually get to the edge. We have ropes set up, so you can get to the edge. We're gonna go here.
Oh.
Now I need a mask.
We just got this swirling of gases. Yeah, I could feel the heat right there.
Yes.
Really see it there.
Yes.
You got a good look.
I've never seen anything of this magnitude and power. And you can feel the power in the ground. What is it about the lava that you love?
People are afraid of this, but this is what it really makes you feel alive. This is one of the things amazing of nature or the universe that you can actually see in person.